the layout of this mall was so cool just because it had... Hey guys, this is a downtown lunch hour walk, and we're currently in David Pecaut Square. Right there, you can see Roy Thomson Hall. You get the Toronto Symphony plays in there. And it's also the fictional headquarters of the Amazon show called The Boys. Great show. It's a superhero show, but it's twisted, corrupt superheroes. It's definitely not a show for kids. Hey puppies! Hey puppies! And we have somebody getting some exercise in there. There's cute puppies running around. All right, let's get started on the walk here. We're going to go east along King Street for a little bit. And it's definitely becoming autumn here because it is cooling down. You can see people are wearing hoodies and long pants, no shorts. You will see the odd person wearing a t-shirt here and there, but that's a little far and few between now. Get you guys a view down in the courtyard area there. You can see some of the stars on the Toronto walk here. Thank you. As you can see, this area's got a lot of high buildings. Heading into the financial district. So you can see the patios and restaurants. I don't know if... I thought I'd heard that restaurants are they were going to be allowed shortly to open up at, I think it was 50% capacity, if they're not already. And then there's talk that they might go to stage three, which I think at that point, it's no restrictions. Oh. It's kind of a lot of people were a little pissed off because Maple Leafs were allowed to have a full house for their home opener. No restrictions. Everyone's jammed in there. They're drinking beer. They're yelling, screaming. But you tell these restaurants, oh, guess what? You can't do that. They can have 18,000 or 16,000 or whatever the number is packed in for the hockey game, but they can't do full capacity for the restaurant. It, to me, it didn't make any sense. Anyways, there's been backlash about that, and hopefully these restaurants get to open up because they're not going to make it. It's Scotia Plaza, I guess. We got a coffee shop here, Daily Ritual Cafe. It's right at Yonge and King, so I mean, their rent must be incredibly high. Hopefully they're selling a lot of lattes to make that rent.
speak with.
Thank you.
I always thought the layout of this mall was so cool just because it had this long stretching high glass ceiling that goes all the way across. I mean, nowadays with all these malls that are being built and they're renovated and upgraded, it might not seem really all that spectacular, but back in the day, this was pretty amazing. But I think I need a new pair of shoes soon. I've been, with all the walking I do, I go through different types of shoes pretty quickly, so I haven't been running as much, but still do a lot of walking. Thank you. It's like shopping is picking up, definitely. Still, levels aren't going to be back, or won't be back for a while still, to what they used to be pre-pandemic. Especially now, because everyone during the pandemic got used to doing the online shopping even more than they were before. So trying to change that behavior, get people to stop getting their Amazon deliveries and go into a brick and mortar store is going to be kind of difficult, I think. So in order to get into that seating area there, you have to be vaccinated, you have to show proof of vaccination and government ID to show that that proof of vaccination is actually you. You can still come down here, order food, pick up food, but you just can't sit in this area here and eat. Alright guys, well that's the food court area, and I think I'm going to cut the video short here. Thanks very much for watching guys, and I'll catch you.